It's our pleasure to have two experts in medical education today. Professor Hamza Abdulghani. He is a consultant and head of assessment and evaluation unit in the medical education department, College of Medicine, King Saud University. Professor Hamza is my teacher, but he is always denying that. I don't know why he wants to be younger. Also, Dr. Nihal Khamis, she is assistant professor. She is the head of faculty assessment unit, medical education, KSU. So please welcome with me Dr. Hamza Abdulghani.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين. It is really my pleasure. يسرني ويشرفني in that time coming and sharing with you a workshop. I was just asking Professor Hani that have you applied this? He said no. We are going to apply. That's really very good move towards the teaching and assessment. There are different tools for assessment, different tools for teaching, but this is the one really which is teaching and assessment. We'll see within a minute. How many of you resident, please you just raise your hand from 1 to 4. Oh, so quite good. And consultant or mean the trainer for postgraduate trainers. Oh, so very few. I mean, majority of you are really resident. That's very nice that at least we have few. But I think really to apply good that maybe we are going to have a separate workshop for really consultant and trainer. So that's the, so we are going to discuss mainly Mini-Cex, mini clinical examination evaluation exercise. But it is a ضمن المنظومة الكبيرة, what they call it, workplace-based assessment. When we say the workplace, where we're really working. So that's the one, and we are assessing our trainee, or our candidate, or our undergraduate, or postgraduate students in the workplace, not just. That's the one whole idea about that. And one of it is the Mini-Cex. Professor Hani was telling us, that will go towards why workplace-based assessment. وش عندنا مو طبعا عندنا وسكي وعندنا ورل وعندنا lot of written exam, a lot of other things and short answer questions, long answer questions. There are a lot of things out there. Why this workplace assessment and mainly Mini-Cex? So that's, we really look at it and then what are these? So what are they? And I mean, there are so many tools. I will just go very brief about those. And then we stress on mainly on the Mini-Cex. What are literatures? Really, I have done a workshop for pediatric program, family medicine, because I'm a family physician for that. We did for orthopedic also. And lot of literatures in medical education about this specialty, either undergraduate or postgraduate. It is actually starting the postgraduate. But even many undergraduate colleges, we have also included in the final year and as well as internship, but many, many postgraduate, they have using it. I couldn't find really literatures about ophthalmology. And I was telling to Professor Mzani that this is a really good chance that to evaluate yourself when you're applying this to that. There's not much, and I didn't find, even Dr. Nihal, she was searching for that. I got a document which is written by the Royal College of Ophthalmology from UK, and they have made a document about 25 or 30 pages about the assessment, and that they have put the workplace assessment with the all tools. So what I know that in UK, almost all program, postgraduate program, they have include workplace-based assessment for mainly for clinical competencies. There are MCQs, there are other things. So that's just brief about that. Very important, and I have put that, maybe we discuss, we may practically we do that, we tell you what is that. Some feedback is a part and participle of any workplace assessment. So let us just go through that. So how many of you aware of this pyramid or triangle? Raise your hand. No, it doesn't matter. Just I want to know that. So it is. It was proposed by educationist again, George Miller, very famous, and is published in very reputable journal, Academic Medicine, in 1992 or 1993, I think, 90. And he proposed a framework for assessment. And he said that definitely our it is undergraduate or postgraduate, we have to assess knowledge, cognitive part or component, and we have to have assess also show level, that is their skills, and usually we do and OSCE, but it has to be also assess does level, what he can do in the real life. At that time was really very hazy that how you can assess someone really working and with patient. So that's really, it was that time was really difficult. But then after that, people have started thinking about and so on. So that's the cognitive skills. This is, we do it by the MCQ and so here. But this level, and as you go up, it's become more authentic, but more difficult. So that's the thing. So it is looks something like that. So we are looking at the knowledge, applied knowledge, and we are looking at the competencies or skills, but we are looking at the performance, real practice. So in OSCE, usually, I don't know, in the postgraduate, in OSCE is included? Yeah, it's there. So usually you say that our candidate has to wash hand, this is the one, the professional behavior and so on. So this has shown that in OSCE, what they show you, not really practice in the real practice. So this, therefore, we have to look at our candidate at this level, at the performance level. So that's the difference between, just slight difference, some people, between competence, which has been identified by us, put the descriptor for us, but the performance, really what they're doing. This is said by, again, one of very famous educationists, the curriculum instruct teacher what to teach. So there's the curriculum, you know that, the, all consultants, they're having the curriculum, what to teach about. But the, really, the assessment is instruct the student what to learn. So if you have a lot of emphasis on your written exam, they're going to read. But you have a lot of emphasis on your clinical aspects, they're going to work in clinic more and more. And they're going to improve their things. The very important, again, finding that really there is an intimate relationship between the assessment and learning. And the other finding that you really, as a trainee, especially they are moving from year one to year two, year three and four, studies have shown they are not well observed and given feedback. Professor Asrar left very famous tutor, and he, so several times he has got that he's not with us. So he's a very good teacher, very good professor, and very good tutor for junior people. But whatever, we have that type of caliber, and others also in respect for all. But studies have shown that trainees are seldom observed, assessed, and given feedback for in workplace. So what you're doing, we watch our juniors and we give the feedback. And formative assessment to say that where we not worry much about the final assessment. So usually with education state, the formative assessment and the summative assessment. Formative assessment usually too. So formative assessment and feedback does the powerful tool for change the behavior. I'm going a bit fast because we want to apply those. Anything, any point, you can stop me and then we can discuss more about that. I'm very happy that since I think two years, so the commission is forcing that there should be
competencies. Competencies should be based on CanMed, that the seven competencies, there's something that has changed. And from there, they have forced you to include the assessment, which is usually used all over the world. So it's not only Mini-Cex, maybe it is a one step. So there are something else also at the workplace-based assessment, which is going to end. So everywhere there is a competencies, and these competencies, what we're talking about. And if we go to the performance level, that's how we are going to assess. Those are things we're talking. Very recently, that Saudi Med competencies also has been launched for undergraduate level. And when we were discussing with Saudi Commission, they said, oh, if we had before, we would apply Saudi Med than the really CanMed. Now, so usually when we're talking about the CanMed competencies or outcomes, what they really look for? So they look for emphasis on competencies, what are these and the competent. Emphasis on the behavior and performance, and that is the one which is really a bit difficult. Competencies we can assess. And also emphasis on the non-discipline specific competencies. Communication skills. Usually we don't look at it much. If a candidate got the whole history, what he wants to do, whatever the way, even that he's not very fit in the communication skills, okay, but no. The communication is one of the pillar in your CanMed. Usually how we assess the competency through the OSCE. But studies have shown that performance, you assess the competence, but does not really reflect on the performance. Any comment? Any difference? And why they're telling that if you assess competencies, then it does not really predict the performance. It means that at the end of your rotation, if you are doing your assessment through the OSCE, and you said this guy are very clearly passed, one or two, they are failed. What is the failure rate in your program? We have about 3 to 4% failure rate in family medicine. What's your failure rate? That's good, excellent. So whatever the 99% who pass, we are not sure really that they are competent, but they are not really going to show the same skills in their real life. That was that. So that's why these things are. So coming to the cycle of learning and become competent, something looks like that. Learning taking place, and we assess. We assess R1, definitely they are different from the R4. So what are the things they should learn? So we observe and give feedback. And again, we assess. We took the learning, and we assess. And the cycle is going on from year one, day one, to year four or five. Four. So year four at the last day. So we say usually, now people are talking about the mastery. They are your resident. They should not be just borderline. They should master these skills. So they master. But mastery does not come like that. It's not they enter in the first day of your residency, and at the last day, they are really competent. It's not like that. Something is like that. So a student or the they came here, they have been trained, and then they come into practice. So it has come like this. You assess, give feedback, assess, give feedback, assess, give feedback. So something like this. So whatever the skills, whatever the competencies they are going to learn to apply in the performance, it will not come just like that. So every time you have to look at it. That's the one which is looking through the workplace-based assessment. Let us look at it. So what are these performance? Definitely clinical encounter, how to take history, how to examine the patients, how to manage. This is the one. But it's not only that, also procedure skills and the professional behavior. It's becoming as a main part of your competencies. So performance-based assessment, that was really introduce the workplace-based assessment. Because here, you're really looking at the at your trainee that how he's dealing with patient. If it's a first-year student, definitely they have, so what are the really skills they are lacking and they have to learn? And what are the skills they have really learned and has to be improved? So you are looking at, so that's why this was introduced as workplace assessment, observe assessment. Very important. That the, you have to be there. And لما احنا بدينا في undergraduate فكانوا في بعض الأقسام بدون ذكر اسم يقول الطالب روح شوف الحالة وبعدين تعال وبعدين أنا ناقشك ونعبي الفورمة. لا. علمني إيش سويت إيش الحالة. والله في case of appendicitis and he came in this way and that and now he's going for operation was done and لا. It has to be observed. He's taking history how. So it is observed assessment of clinical practice in workplace. So أول شرط in observe you have seen candidate working with patient in clinic or in OR or in certain procedures, but he's working in the real context with feedback to learner to strengthen weakness of her performance or his performance. So definitely, if he's R4, he's having a lot of strength. But you as a consultant, you as a trainer, can find out what are the weaknesses and what are the things he has to improve. Not only that, it was also said that you raised that you have this type of strength. This has to be continued. لما احنا نعمل عندنا في family medicine, we do that. So لما نيجي نقول كيس, what are the things you have done well? قال دكتور انا سويت اشياء كده, سيب دحين قول لي, what are the areas I have to improve? I said, no. It is also important that you should know what you're doing well. And then we'll discuss what are the things to be changed and practiced. There are so many we are going to discuss today, Mini-Cex. A majority of these tools was developed in states. كان عندهم حاجة, they would call it long case, and it was also for the teaching, which usually take 2 hours to teach everything and so. And then the Dr. Norsini has developed that, and so many others also. So he developed for that within short period, snapshot was the professor, then he was telling you. Within short, today let us look at how he take history. Let us look at how he do the procedures. Let us look at how that, and we can give the feedback. So that's the things, it came, so many tools. So there, these are the, I mean, three very famous. Mini-Cex, direct observation of procedures. You have a lot of procedures. Every trainee, especially, he's going to start with a procedure, isn't it? And he, under your supervision. So you look at it and give constructive feedback. And then you again look at it next time, other times, and so on. Multi-source feedback, or the 360 degree, how he's working with colleague, with others, and so on. We'll see. I have some very small clip, then we can explain all this. Professionalism, Mini-Cex, there are so many tools, but let us really, that. There was so many literatures about these are the things which is Mini-Cex, case-based discussion. So your trainee has seen a case, he wrote the records and he recorded the things and so, and then you discuss with him what you have done and so. Direct observations of the procedure skills, multi-source feedback, professionalism, mini exercise, mini pattern, so many are there, even patient satisfactions. So what they are doing, especially I know the UK system, that all these applied to a residency program from year 1 to year 5, year 4, and the only part, which this is all for the clinical part, and only what they are assessing the cognitive part, which is MCQ. And other than that, all these in this way. So as we said that there are so many tools out there, let us look at in really, so these are three are all focused on the assessment of specific skills. starting with performance in the real clinic. That's the way I'm repeating that in the clinic, in with patients, or in ER, or in theater, or doing procedures. So real practice, based around the focus task, a rating performance across the several skills required a lot, and they have a lot of reliability for that. Okay, so let me, before I just pass, let me show you a small video. Very, very small, just to have a
And as we discussed outside, Dr. Fuller will be sitting in to observe today, if that's okay.
Hello.
So, tell me all about it.
Well,
so this is a patient who came as a trainee. Usually, this is the video which is played to just to teach people and how it is done and so. And this is the trainer who is sitting behind. And he's having a marking sheet to give the feedback to candidate. Very important, the first important that it is the clinical context where he is dealing with real patient. Then the tutor or the consultant or the trainer, he's sitting behind. Patient is a real patient and the trainee, and he's going to take the history or doing the examination and so. And after that, there's the feedback sessions. Let us look at it. Just is it really small, just to show you what's going on?
Again, about 6 months ago, the vision in my right eye went blurry, and that lasted about 2 weeks. It gradually got better, and then I was fine till about 3 months ago, when I had an episode of dizziness and unsteadiness. I felt awful and sick.
Okay, I'm just going to give you your eye a little test. Now, me too.
So, very small snapshot of the taking history about the patient who is presented with the blurring vision and so on. So he just taken the history. We showed very small, but usually it'll go for the 5 to 6 minutes or 7 minutes to take the history and do the examination. So then he came to do the examination. Again, trainer is standing behind to look at and give the feedback.
Look into my eye. Do you see this pin as red?
Yes.
Okay, and I want you to tell me when you see the pin, head as red.
The Mini-Cex is a tool that we can use in any clinical setting. The first part of the form allows you to indicate the setting: inpatient, outpatient, accident and emergency room. You can indicate whether the patient is new or a follow-up, and the complexity of the problem.
So first of all, they say that where it is. It is a clinic, or it is ER, or it is so and so. Even that your form, it is there. So first,
no,
you identify.
No. You can also indicate,
so it was outpatient,
the clinical encounter, whether it relates to data gathering, diagnosis, or issues relating.
What type of case it is? Is it very difficult? No, it looks like moderate type of case. What is really assessing over that? So really diagnostic skills of the candidate.
To management or giving advice. You can also indicate a brief description of the nature of the clinical problem. You then score.
And then there is descriptors. We'll see in your also form that it is usually when it started is 1 to 9. So 1, where really it is, 1 to 3 usually unsatisfactory, and so. So 1 to 9. But we, people adapted. We made 6. I think yours also 1 to 6. Some of the people they make it 1 to 5, and so it is adapted all over the world. But initially, when it started, it was 1 to 9. People they found that is 1 to 9 is quite big things.
What you have observed on a 9-point scale, 1 to 3 being poor, 4 to 6 satisfactory, and 7 to 9 good. The areas that can be observed include medical interviewing skills, physical examination skills, consideration for the patient and professionalism, clinical judgment, counselling and communication skills, organisation and efficiency.
So that's the real 6 or 7 what you can say that area would they are going to really assess. It's not necessary that every area we have to. So here there was, can we say that there's no snapshot? What are the area we were looking for? in this video? Anyone? So interviewing, mainly the interviewing skills and some amount of the physical examination skills, isn't it? It is a snapshot just to show us. So these are the two areas mainly. You can say also the professionalisms or slight of the communication, but mainly we are assessing here the two things there.
And a comment on the overall clinical competence.
And then we say that whole over, that what is the overall after that, the six competency vehicle.
Once you have filled in the form, you then discuss the mini-CEX with your trainee. This allows you to give the trainee positive feedback when they have done things well, or recognize weaknesses and endeavor to resolve them if needed.
I think that's the most important part of this exercise. The mini-CEX, we are going to role play it here. That you observe your trainee did well at some of the area to be. So that we sit with the trainee and we discuss what was went well and what the area we want to improve that. And there's really agreement between the trainer and the trainee that what the area to be. So this is the part which is the most essential part. If you watch and just tick the descriptor or the number that you got five in that, and six in that, and seven in that, does not mean anything. You can just give that and it'll go. But if you finish your case and just discuss altogether, there's a lot of studies not take more than 15 to 20 minutes. So usually it go for the 10 to 15 minutes for that and then 5 to 10 minutes for that. But this is not in ophthalmology. I have seen in medicine, in surgery, in family medicine, and so on. I'm not sure about the literature in the ophthalmology.
Joe, it's very good to have the opportunity to watch you during the consultation. How did you think that went?
I thought it went okay.
Yeah. Anything that you think went particularly well?
Well, she was quite forthcoming in her history. She didn't take a lot of and as we discussed outside, Dr. Fuller will be sitting in to observe today, if that's okay.
Hello.
Oh, sorry. So, did you just repeat it? I was just waiting for.
How did you think that
was? So, that's the one which is going, the interaction between the trainer and trainee
anything
to show what has been done.
Well.
And usually there is an agreement between the two that what to be done later and what you're going to do and so. I'll just show you the other clips just to have an idea about that. So this is again, usually the procedural skills. So here you again watch and give
Docs
the feedback.
Uses the same principles as the mini-CEX.
Very short, just a minute or 1.5 minutes.
Procedures and uses the same 9-point scoring system. The form is generic and covers issues such as understanding of the indication for an investigation, an appropriate use of analgesia or sedation, technical ability and consideration for the patient, as well as issues relating to the management of complications and the interpretation of the result.
So in that, we usually we're looking at the taking history, doing examination, that's the mini-CEX. But here, because the procedures, and you have a lot of procedures, so in the procedure skills, we are looking for the understanding the indication for investigations, so he's explaining to the patient what we done and what we're going to do, appropriate use of the analgesia if there is something like lumbar puncture and so on. Technical ability, that's the most important part of that, how he's doing and so, and other things.
Trainees and consultants found the DOPS to be practical, fair, and helpful. And about 40% of consultants learned additional useful information about their trainees having assessed them during a procedure. A reliable assessment was obtained when three observers each saw two procedures.
So that's the, just a snapshot of the two tools we are really stressing today, mainly about the workplace assessment. Let us just look at that, what else in the work. Okay, so mini-CEX, it was a response to the problem of KKESH 2 hours. هذا اللي تكلمت معكم in American College of Medicine when Professor John Norsini, he was asked to look at يا أخي إحنا نعلم we teach our candidate and we observe and give the feedback. It'll take 2 hours. That's too much. We cannot do it. So what? So then he adopted that you can take what you do in that because he's a non-medical person. He's just psychometricians. He says, what? But he's a medical educationist. What are you doing that? So we teach them how to take history. We teach them how to take examination. We observe what to do there, how they manage the case and so. I said, why not to make it a snapshot? So take that separately, and then you can look at it in the different things. So that was really so short observations during the clinical patients. Contact 10 to 15 minutes, and then you get 5 to 10 minutes of feedback. And usually, there is a generic evaluation form. So, for all cases, that's the form which is we are going to see at the 6 or 7 competencies, which are generic for all. It's not like OSCE. You have to prepare for OSCE that every OSCE has to have the different descriptors. It's not like that. It's generic. So that's the one we discuss about that, the medical interviewing skill, physical examination skills, and so on and so on. Fine. Here, as we said, that could be anywhere. Inpatient, outpatient, emergency, procedures, whatever it is. Take into the account of context, complexity. If a kernel case is very complex and it's very junior, so you are going to assess at that level. But R4 is going to have more than that. Doesn't matter, but the death level. So complexity is important. Focus of visit, diagnosis, management, follow-up, what type of things. Each assessment capture a snapshot of clinical practice. That's the very important part. It's not the full case. And usually if the full case, there's something else. So use the standard form, not customized to the particular patients or problem. Is a standard force, which you're going to see within a minute, and usually complete 6 to 10 encounters. So Dirasat, studies have shown that when you go 6 at least, so that's give the good reliability if you're taking for the final assessment, because the all program in UK is going for the final assessment for the whole workplace, not only the Mini-Cex. So, extensively evaluated in UK and US, consider the validity, reliability, and the feasibility of that. It has been really, really look at it. But really, there is a lot of administrative issues to apply that you have to do. Reliability of the Mini-Cex rises above an acceptable level after the 6 to 8 episodes. So you cannot say that once and this enough. La, you couldn't fee thani, thalith, rabi, and fifth, maybe. The first year you're doing the 2, 3, and the second year doing and so on. So generally reliable and producible, at least 4 to 6 encounter. We discuss about different assessor, different patients. If someone is very strict, like Professor Mazzini, he's going to not give him very high marks, but there are others coming and they are doing it. So that's, you can really compensate with that and you can understand. Most important part is the feedback. Now, this was really so many studies by Norsini and others. They were looking at the different tools of assessment. And they were looking at the time. So time, why they put the time? Because if you increase the number of cases, you have to increase the time. And they were looking at the reliability of the measurement. Which one? You can tell us. That's the more reliable in less time. So they found that within 1 hour, more than 4 cases, within 1 hour, so the reliability goes to 73. So that's why if you have 6 to 8 or even is going to 10, the reliability can go up to 0.96. And we know that when it's reliability is reaching to 1, that's the real reliable case. So that's the one. If you spend it 8 hours and it's not at the once, it is today and after 1 week and after 10 days and next month and so on. What is going on in places where they have applied, that trainee, they keep with them and they run behind the consultant. I have a case to just show you. Just please come and do for me the assessment, because they love the feedback which is given after that. Okay. We can say that. What's the difference between the new? Have you actually and an OSCE? So let's get good enough to add Mini-Cex. What's the difference between the two?
feedback. أحسن. معنا أوسكي إحنا ينرسم ينرجح ولا one is feedback. What else? Exactly, they're going to perform. What else? Real patient. So, ممكن احنا نجيب ال post even real patient, but we are not in the place where he's really working. And we have a snapshot. There is a lot of repetitions once we did and twice and others. So, that's the one. So, most important that the practice, and we'll see just within. So what is needed really for the workplace-based assessment? Really needed the feedback. And I think Dr. Nihal, she will discuss a bit about that. But apart from that, you need, it is a, طبعاً في الأماكن اللي طبقوها, they have already gone for the electronic. But you can produce that and it can go later. So it is electronic. So either you decide that how you're going to produce the paper or the, but still we are in the family medicine, we are doing the paperwork and it is signed there. So workload is increased, administrative cleaning, so your security is going to combine, then has to come up with the results and so on, paper storage and so on. The problem is that if you find out and you applied now, and you have first year and second year and third year, fourth year, you have a problem with the first year, you can correct it. The problem in the second year, you can, yes, you still have time. Whether you have the problem in the fifth year or fourth year, so what to do? Those are the things, those are the issues really to be discussed very clearly. She will going to, so feedback, ترى هم دحين قالوا لكن هذه عندنا في شريعتنا في المؤمن مرات أخي المؤمن نقول له يا أخي أنت تعرف هذا الشيء وهذا لا. So, رحم الله من أهدى إلي عيوبي أظن قول سيدنا عمر الخطاب. So, those are the things really. So, and very important, I just quote one meta-analysis about the feedback. Meta-analysis. Volosky has done the meta-analysis in 2006. And what he found, that impact of various educational strategies. You teaching, whatever the things, you education strategies, in medical education outcomes, feedback alone is effective up to 71%. Meaning to throw the feedback, you can do the 3/4 of your educational activity. Again, feedback promotes and so. But there's a problem with the feedback. A very small study we did with Dr. Hakawi in National Guard. And we were looking for the, what are the barrier? Why people not there? So they said that their system is not clear. Inadequate tutor skills to give feedback. Student fear officer. Which one you think that among these three, the most important? Third one, the student fear of insulting for the getting the feedback could be. But we found that something else. Yeah, exactly. So inadequate, we don't have. We as a tutor, consultant, Ali, 20 sana shaghal fi, and I'm very fit to deal with the patients and teach and so, but I don't have the skills of feedback and so on. So just I'm concluding that. So workplace is developed to introduce the assessment clinical competency through the repeated performance. That's the most important. And there were so many, but these are the three which is really affected very well. This is some take home message. Are we going to apply one, I think is the time that we can wait for 10 more minutes. Then we go for prayer, then come back. Is this the way, or you're going to finish and then we go for prayer? We have 50 minutes, that's excellent. Like when Ahmed Dr. Rahman,
what you all today here?
I have left eye redness and pain.
And I'm sorry, how old are you?
28.
And you've had this problem for only the last 2 days?
Yep.
And can you describe the redness? How did it start?
It started suddenly, yes, around 2 days ago with severe pain, severe aching pain.
And have you had this these symptoms before? Have you had
no, it's
similar symptoms before? Your first time? and this redness and this pain is preventing you from sleeping.
Yeah.
Is so severe.
Severe pain. Yeah.
Very severe pain. And is it combined with the discharge and tearing?
No.
Nothing like that?
Nothing.
And have you had any change in your vision?
Yeah.
You feeling you have?
Somehow, yeah.
And that started also 2 days ago.
Yeah.
Is it a progressing or still?
The pain is the same. It's so severe.
I mean the change of your vision.
No.
Is it the same or
no,
still
the same, yeah.
Same thing? And have you had like any trauma, any injury
no
to your
trauma.
Eye? Nothing like that. Have you had any contact with any sick patient with a
no.
similar problem?
Nothing.
Nothing like that. And have you had any medications, anything in the few last days?
No, nothing.
Nothing like that. Do you feel? Do you have any problem like diabetes or hypertension?
I have hypertension.
And for how long have you had that?
Like 5 years.
And you're taking medication
yeah.
for that? Okay. Okay, Mr. Abdulrahman, have you had a similar problem in your other eye or
no.
only in your left eye?
First time.
First time. Okay. You don't have any discharge?
No discharge.
Nothing like that?
Just redness and severe pain.
Okay.
So severe pain that sometimes I feel nausea.
Uh-huh. Okay. Are you like allergic from any food or drugs?
No.
Nothing like that? And you don't have any similar condition in your family?
No.
Okay. So what about your like you don't having any like floaters anything you're seeing anything like this nothing like that? Okay.
Only redness and severe aching pain with some nausea.
With the nausea.
Yeah.
You didn't have any other symptoms?
No other
like
symptoms.
Vomiting or something like
no,
this?
No, just nausea that I feel like I would like to throw up.
Okay. Have you had the flu symptoms the last few days?
No.
Nothing like that?
Nothing like that.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Do you have any general diseases in your family? And
just the hypertension and diabetes.
That's all?
That's all.
Mm-hmm. And you're not complaining of any other symptoms?
No, just redness, pain, and nausea.
That's all.
That's
all. Okay. Do you have any other else? Anything else you want to tell me?
That's it.
That's all.
Yeah.
Okay.
Doctor.
Yeah, I think. So, Mr. Abdulrahman is how old?
28.
Yeah, he's 28 years old.
Should I talk to him? To whom?
Okay, I thought you. Okay.
No.
Okay. So, Mr. Abdulrahman, according to your description of your problem, it looks like you're having an infection that just started 2 days ago, and with this nausea, it looks like you're having this kind of symptoms that it's more likely goes with an infection. And as long as you don't have any diseases that we might be afraid of, so most likely that you're having a very simple infection to your eyes. But we have to make sure that there isn't anything else that's going on. So we have to do a full examination to you, and we need to make sure that it is the only problem you're having, and we need to confirm it with our test. Then we can confirm our diagnosis.
We are about to start. عايزين نعرف الأول هدفنا منه إيه. One of the things we always talk about, and we introduce Mini-Cex in order to achieve a good degree of objectivity in assessment. والحاجة التانية لتقليل الانتريتر variability. المفروض إنه لو إحنا بنستخدم structured tool, which is valid, يعني it tests what it tends to test, بdescriptors كويسة, بwhat we call metrics. لأنه من الحاجات الـ recent trends in medical education إنه زمان لما كنا بنعمل checklist كان من المنطقي وكتير قوي إنك تلاقي مكتوب إيه مثلاً he shows effective communication skills he takes history appropriately كويس فلما حضرتك بتدخل to the exam what might look appropriate for me might be different than what looks appropriate لحد تاني ممكن أنا عندي higher standards ف appropriate for me is much more sophisticated ممكن تكون أنت R1 أو أنت R4 لما إحنا الاثنين مكتوب لنا appropriate especially لو ما كانش فيه حاجة benchmark بنرجع له الكلام الجديد ما بنعملش كده I just arrived yesterday. I'm working as a member of the curriculum committee at the American College of Surgeons. Where this posts like the curriculum and policies for all the residents in the states when it comes to surgery. من الحاجات اللي قاعدين نناقشها كتير قوي وكده اللي هو how to put the matrix. كل ده ليه؟ علشان حاجتين. علشان الحاجة الأولانية لما حضرتك تتعلم تتعلم صح. يعني إيه تتعلم صح؟ يعني زمان لما كنا بنيجي نتكلم for instance عن something like oh والله sorry انا I thought you're all only Arabic speakers or bilingual speakers so what I was saying that all of the efforts currently are directed towards the objectivity we are to have very clear cut-off points or matrix على every and each step في the clinical skills assessment process. For instance, when we were talking about suturing, في the old days, you would say that he sutured something appropriately or well or in the right manner or things like this. And as such, can feed tendency more towards the use of rating skills. We find that it's written, it's done competently or incompetently, for instance, or not done, and things like this. The current trends is to go for clear metrics. Yani when I talk about suturing, I start by appropriate approximation of the wound. Or appropriate approximation of the wounds, we put identifiers. No overlap, no distance more than whatever millimeters. When it comes to sutures nafsa, we speak about the sutures are spaced like how many millimeters. So world is moving towards, in medical education, is moving more towards objectivity, more clear descriptors, in order to minimize inter-teachers or inter-raters differences, and for the sake of standardization. And when it comes from where we derive those standards or metrics, it's all evidence-based. And we rely on research. It's not anymore the school of Dr. Fulan or the school of Professor whoever, with all the respect of all the clinical, long clinical experience. And we refer to evidence-based literature, and we get from them the metrics of writing how to do this. During the exercise that we had now, we distributed you into two groups. One of the groups had descriptors, although not very much detailed descriptors, but something which says, what about these competencies? It describes what is expected from the resident. The other group didn't have the descriptors. Our intention from this is that we compare the differences in the rating between the group with the descriptors with other group to show how much this might differ. The other thing we want to talk about, we also test the inter-raters differences even with the presence of structured form. وده في الحقيقة, this is intended more for the teachers rather than for the residents, to highlight the importance of faculty development, training on the structured formats we are using. And in many of the instances, no clear training takes place, يعني just the forms are distributed to the teachers, they take it, and we take for granted and there will be objective assessment. Let us see now how have you evaluated the exercise that we've gone through. You've evaluated for interviewing skills and for counseling and communication. خلينا نشوف الانترفيورز. الانترفيوينج سكيلز. في الجزء اللي ما كانش معاه غير الريتنج فورم بس. No descriptors. How many rated him like two? Raise your hands. احنا في الانترفيوينج سكيلز. مين شايف انه ياخد two? ما فيش. 3 4. الجروب ده دكتور حمزه الجروب ده معاه ديسكريبتور اخر طيب هنا how many rated him as 4 1 2 3. طيب وفي الجروب ده حد rated as 4 1 2. طيب top 5. طيب the majority هنا as 5 with the majority as 5. Time. When it comes to the communication skills or counseling skills, the group that has the descriptors had rated at 2, 3, 4, 1 at 4. The rest all for 5. MashaAllah. Time. The group without descriptors who rated as 2? 1. Who rated as 3? Who rated as 4? Who rated as 5? وفي ناس didn't rate خالص ولا ايه؟ The bonus. Fine. Who gave him bonus? 1, 2, 3, 4. The group with descriptors, who rated him as 6 with bonus? Nobody. Top for interview, skill had the 6? تعالوا review مع بعض the results. هو طبعا من الواضح ان احنا جي حظنا في candidate قوي. فالأجريمنت عليه is really nice, لكن still with the group of descriptors كان يعني النمبر اللي ادى 4 بيزيد 1 عن الجروب الثاني. I don't see really a major inter-rater differences between within the same group ولا within the two groups when it comes to the interviewing skills. تعالوا نشوف على الكونسلينج سكيلز. الكونسلينج سكيلز حصلت حاجة في الجروب اللي هو معهوش descriptors. في حد ادى 2 وفي حد ادى 4. الماجوريتي ادت 5 وفي 4 ادوا 6. ده معناه ان انا ممكن لو حظي يوقع في لجنة فيها حد من اللي ادى 1 وفيها حد من اللي ادى like 6, يبقى انا اللي بيقيموني واحد ادى 1 واحد ادى 6. And really there is a huge great difference between, you know, the same candidate يبقى rated as 6, the bonus, and rated at the level of 2. يعني he is below the expected level. That's what we are afraid about. And that's why you should be cautious even with the use of structured formats. في حاجات ما يعني some of the items there isn't a lot of differences for rating versus others. Usually the variations الكتير comes more with something like counseling or communication. Why? Counseling and communication metrics بتاعتها are usually purely qualitative. الحاجات التانية احيانا الماتريكس are either quantitative, semi-qualitative. يعني what do we mean with what we're saying? When I say something about the counseling, for instance, it's descriptive. You describe some form of behavior. Fine? فالobjective judgment here is much more difficult than, for instance, if you're doing a procedure and you have metrics like in the form of centimeters, meters, or something quantitative. The other thing when it comes to the communication and counseling has to do with the cultural differences. Something which is quite important when it comes to communication, the cultural differences and how you're addressing the patient, how you're caring for this diversity, and things like this. What we want to say, when it comes to Mini-Cex, it's quite important you care for proper training on the use of many CX formats. This is number one. Number two, the presence of very clear descriptors for each of the competencies.
Dr. Hamza, طبعاً spoke in a lot of details about the Mini-Cex. I'm interested in we just focus on some important aspects quickly, like to assure some take-home messages. There is a very important question when it comes to education, which is, what do we assess? In the exams you have entered through, whether when you were students or just after graduation, if you enter something thereafter, the important questions that we need to seek answer for. Do students study to pass the exams? Do we assess the students' ability to pass the exams, or do we assess the students' ability to become good doctors? What do you think? Usually, especially in the undergraduates, our main, especially when it comes to the written exams, our main target is passing the exam. We not only على فكرة وردوا in the cognitive part or the written part, even in the clinical exam. What are the differences? Huge differences. يعني for instance, Dr. Hamza was mentioning something like washing hands. أو أكتر الأجزاء اللي عايزين نقول عليها when it comes to attitudes and behaviors. Usually in the exam, you could simulate the behavior, yes? لكن does this reflect your own attitude ولا لا؟ يعني إيه الكلام الملخبط؟ Attitudes, this is your inherent beliefs and values. فلو أنا in the exam, I'm just targeting passing the exam, and if you are being examined on only certain very limited encounters, يبقى ممكن you imitate, you have the attitude. You simulate this. You pretend like. طيب. لما جينا نفكر كتير ازاي ما نخليش الناس to study to pass the exam. ما ينفعش. Everyone is targeted towards passing the exams. Can I have help here? خلاص. Okay. الإجابة, the answer to this question has changed a lot the way how medical education is being structured, or learning experiences are being planned. لأنه قمنا أسأله ببساطة إنه if we managed to reach the point where passing the exam predicts you're being a good doctor, then when you study for the exam, which is a natural something, يعني natural inherent something for students, you would become a good doctor. فابتدى هنا ال الكلام عن الاسسمنت gets different. ابتدينا نقول ان doctor's performance capabilities are a critical factor in determining what is to be learned, which is the curriculum, and what is to be tested. فما عادتش القصه انه targeting the exam او targeting ان انا فرحانه قوي that I finished a book من الجلده للجلده, لكن بقى في حاجه ثانيه that we are looking for. ايه هي بقى؟ What do we test our physicians, our future physicians for? We are expected to test or to assess our residents, our students, or whoever in the role that is expected from them after graduation. يعني لازم يكون الeducation ولازم يكون الassessment are relevant for the future practice. فبدينا نقول إنه doctors are expected to be competent to do what? To diagnose, plan management, carry out practical procedures, expected in the same time to behave in a reasonable way, demonstrating a caring and humanistic attitude while doing so. The change لقصة إنه I look at the outcome started this way. فبقينا لما نيجي نتكلم عن assessment or whatever, it's like we draw a profile. كده I imagine, I draw a profile how I would like my physician to look like. وابتدت القصة دي something called the five stars the doctor. وابتدي حط this profile. His collaborator, his communicator, his like you see what helps the physician to perform the role which is expected of him. القصة دي أنا كلها بقولها عشان أوصل لحاجة أنه all over the time we're talking to you in terms of competencies. This is these are the competencies and these are what is expected from you. Usually people are not very much aware of what does competencies mean. In many of the instances, for you, competencies is equivalent to skills. صح؟ Competencies are not skills. Competencies are integration of knowledge, skills, and attitudes. And I'll give an example for this. Usually, for years, we were talking in the term of communication skills. If you are to be an effective communicator, you should be having the knowledge of how to start a rapporteur, for instance, with a patient. What are the questions that you should ask during taking history? صح ولا غلط? What are the components of taking history? This is pure knowledge. And then you have the skills, the psychomotor skills of how you are pronunciating, how you are using the tone of your voice, and things like this. An important part of communication as well is attitudes. Have you introduced yourself to the patient? How are you directing your speech with the patients? And things like this. How you are keeping the privacy of the patient. So when we're talking about competencies all over the time, this means an integration of knowledge, skills, and attitudes. وعشان كده ابتدت تظهر many frameworks for competencies, منهم the KKESH, the one which you are currently using. El clinical assessment, but a clinical competence assessment. It's not anymore scattered objectives or things like this. The types of clinical assessments that Dr. Hamza said, فيهم simulated and فيهم authentic. The simulated, اللي احنا بنتكلم عنه, the OSCE, it's not enough alone because it's artificial. Artificial, يعني it's very much essential at a certain stage of your training, but it's not enough. It's artificial, it's structured, it's safe, it's secure. You're going from your home out on this morning, you know that you're going to a test, you've slept well, you've taken your sandwiches or whatever, you're ready, you have read, and then you get to the exam room where everything is ready. Retinoscope is here, batteries are there, all equipments are ready, the setting artificial. Authentic, this real uses a real context, yani direct observation of a student caring for a real patient with a real problem in a real setting. This is unstandardized. Unstandardized means something. And you are subjected to system-related influences and individual-related influences. Can you give me an example for this? خلينا نتكلم على system-related influences. What might happen in the workplace which is not present in an OSCE? Low battery in the retinoscope, for instance. Retinoscope is not around. ما بيحصلش؟ بيحصل. طيب ايه تاني؟ انا I've seen this new retinoscope has been bought and introduced to the clinic, no training, for they are starting to see how this could work, for instance. ايه تاني حاجات relevant to the system؟ انه you are subjected to any type of patient. صحيح في الامتحانات they guarantee انه if they are selecting the patients for you هيبقوا واخدين بالهم of what they are getting, انما there is diversity. احيانا عيان متفق مع ما جاش مش عارف مين فما بتبقاش القصه لايك انه الخمسه سته ستاندردايزد بيشنتس او اللي هم روتيتنج اند اكزيستنج. حاجات كتير ممكن تحصل, حاجه ممكن في السيستم, حاجه ممكن في الميديكال انفورماتكس, حاجه ممكن في البريسكريبشن اند وات ايفر. طب وات اباوت الانديفيديوال ريليتد انفلوينسز؟ Do you feel the same level of stress في الاوسكي like في الوركبلايس؟ Which is more stressful? OSCE is more stressful for you. المفروض يبقى العكس. If you trained well for the OSCE, لو انتوا اخدتوا well briefing for the OSCE, كل الليتريتشر المفروض الاوسكي يبقى فيها degree of stress is less than the workplace. لان الworkplace exam more or less, او الworkplace performance يعني more or less بيبقى الvariables فيه اكتر. Fine? Regardless, في اختلافات موجودة ما بين الاثنين which necessitates that we judge the way you're practicing in the workplace and not only في the artificial context of الاوسكي. الكلينيكال اسسمنت ميثودز كتيرة والدكتور حمزة has mentioned them and I want to talk about best two things عشان to identify the importance of using Mini-Cex. قلنا دكتور حمزة mentioned a single faculty member evaluating the students as he performed complete history and physical examination on a pre-selected patient in the hospital. You are expected to reach diagnostic and therapeutic conclusions, to present your findings, to produce a written report of the patient. وكنا بنقول ان this is more like 2 hours. How realistic is, you know, you take a case in 2 hours? From your practice, how many minutes do you usually spend with each patient? Hmm? 10 minutes? 15 minutes? طيب, if I'm giving you 2 hours to test how you are going to deal with the patient, الحاجة اللي أنت expected to do it just in only 15 minutes in practice. يبقى this is a valid, reliable test. You're not beginner, and you're not be given the time to do this during real practice. يبقى أنا كده I'm not testing you in the same circumstances and conditions that you're gonna practice in. طب إيه تاني؟ صحيح real patient, simultaneous assessment of performance and provision of feedback by a skilled educator. And I wanna say, إنه في الويسترن universities and countries, they were providing feedback مع CX. إنما actually, في أحيان كتيرة in our universities, كان لا. Complete and realistic clinical challenge, this is true. And you take the patient from A to Z, you do all of the clinical reasoning and everything. طيب, إيه هي ال weaknesses؟ تسمع عن حاجة اسمها domain specificity؟ طيب, أنا I'll ask you one clear question. If I examined you in a case of glaucoma for 2 hours, does this predict your performance in other diseases in an ophthalmology? بتلاقوها someone going to the exam and says within those days, يعني, and lucky enough, I had a patient of cataract which I reviewed or I have attended with professor whoever is. ويجي زميلك أو زميلتك وتلاقي إنه at the same time, لا, he didn't study for this, or he مثلا skipped this, or he didn't have the chance to see so many patients about this. يبقى أنا هنا I'm judging your clinical competency based on one disease. I might agree with you على communication with the patient. إنما interviewing might be different. Interviewing communication skills, okay. إنما items for history taking ممكن تختلف. Your plan of management قد تختلف. والexamination might differ from one case to another. المفروض إنه في أي حاجة exam عشان يبقى reliable يبقى عندنا القدرة to take proper sampling. يبقى I take multiple cases or multiple diseases so that I'm able to judge you. في حاجة تانية is quite important. If I tested you or examined you or whatever في الانpatient, does this necessarily predict how you act في الoutpatient أو في الemergency room مثلا for instance? لا. ده مش شرط. صح؟ طيب. الحاجة التانية and we were talking about single examiner. تمام؟ وهنا بيبقى فيه طبعا الميجر انتريترز ديفرنسز. احنا السياكس على فكره they were using structured formats, يعني في فورما مكتوب فيها نفس الحكايه الكومبتنسز اند everything, so it's not about the checklist for evaluation. يبقى الانتريترز ديفرنسز were high. احنا شفنا دلوقتي example for the same competency someone gave 1 and someone gave 6. يعني حد بيقول انه he's not safe for the patient, وحد بيقول ان he is above the expected level. طبعا احنا بنقول انه يعني we say انه even if this happened while you're having two examiners, الضرر is less, the harm is less for the learner, even لو كان the inter-raters differences are high. This is still different than and you use one examiner only بالطريقة اللي هو شايفها. الحاجة التانية انه focuses on the ability to be thorough with a single new patient in a hospital setting uninfluenced by time constraints. ده اللي احنا كنا بنقوله. no time constraints. ولذلك لو أنا examined كده وتعلمت كده, when I come to practice, I'm not fit for practice or ready for practice. طيب, how to counteract الحاجات دي, إيه رأيكو? For the first item, what would you do to overcome this point of weakness? Multiple encounters, صح? طب for the inter-rater differences, multiple raters trained on the use of the form for assessment. طيب, third item, what would you do? Shorter encounters using time frames which are consistent with your future practice. تمام؟ يبقى عندنا هنستعمل different patients, different settings, shorter patient encounters, different faculty members in the overall assessment, or observation on different occasions and different patients. This is exactly the Mini-Cex. اللي هو بقينا focused 4 to 6 encounters, 15 minutes. You have mentioned the actual time you're seeing patients in is around the 15 minutes. Different settings, different assessors. وبالتالي this increases the quality of the assessment and feedback. يبقى although people preferred in the old days an example of CX where you have ample time, it's only one patient, so you don't have to go to stress in multiple encounters. Like at the end, using the Mini-Cex is much more in the favor of the learner or the one who is going through the exams. دي الفورمات اللي احنا استعملناها. This is something more or less nearby. We have developed, me and Dr. Hamza modified for our residents, for our interns in the College of Medicine. These are the descriptors one of the groups have taken while the others didn't. For instance, medical interviewing skills facilitates patient telling of story, effective uses of questions, directions, and so on. اللي عايز أقوله إنه even if these descriptors are here, you are expected during training to have more details descriptors, a checklist for training. يعني for all the teachers who are here, you should be developing checklists that are to be used in training and to be the reference for students when it comes to assessment. هنا كل حاجة يعني each of the items are fully described. This is expected to decrease the inter-raters differences وتخلين ال student نفسه he has the appropriate knowledge of how he's going to be assessed. تمام؟ كده يبقى احنا we're like solidifying, why are we moving towards Mini-Cex? What are the advantages for you as a resident in using this new method of assessment? في حد لسه حاسس انه it's not a good way to shift to Mini-Cex? Feel freely, لانه one of the objectives of our setting today ان احنا we explore your ideas and we reach consensus. مرتاحين انكم هتمتحنوا this way. Do you have any concerns about being tested by Mini-Cex?
I'm afraid that the same thing will happen as sometimes with the evaluation. Like, the consultant will investigate, you will not have the time, so you just take a paper and break you to tell them the things that are appropriate. And the paper is done with the that will assure you. That's going to work. When you're going to break for prayer, they will assure you. That's the key part. So the form is not to just give you marks, it's not to keep.
training, yani, as a part of my work as faculty development programs.
For prayer, because there is a way to pray, and yet we are going to have the feedback sessions here, role play, and then Dr. Ash is going to discuss about the...
In response to your question, during their training, we have a few videotaping. وبنشوف الترينر بيبص على how they're acting and how they're evaluating. They are provided feedbacks. والحاجة التانية بتورى لهم هم videos تكون rated by experts. وبنبص how they have rated these. And we compare. وبالتالي بنصلح the way they are providing assessment in the event.
يعلمون undergraduate يعلمون. Especially sector things. We are not born as a teacher, as a tutor, as a teacher, human. But we learn every day. Less than that, I can tell you, if you exceed more than 5 minutes, and then you will be sitting there and we take the feedback from the people on your performance. Not person, someone who are really teaching us. That's how they give people. Go ahead.
Thank you, Ahmed. I will talk in English, huh?
Yeah.
Well, you did a great job, Ahmed. I'm going to give you my feedback. I will talk about positive things and then the negative things, which are very minimal.
Sounds great.
First, the first session when you were taking history, and then the second session when you were giving your plan and the probable diagnosis for the patient. In the beginning, it was nice that you introduced yourself and you built a good rapport with the patient. You took his name and general history. And the second session, I liked that you were not certain giving the diagnosis because you didn't do examination and the rest of the investigation. While taking history, I noticed that you were asking yes or no questions. Yes or no questions is one type, but which gonna be better if you ask open-ended question. Regarding communication skills, it was nice that you gave the patient a chance to talk to some extent, and you were asking quick, and but you were repeating some questions. That's what I noticed. And you didn't show the maximum empathy that was expected for a patient who was having pain in his eye and he was suffering from that. It was nicer if you were, if you said that, I'm sorry to hear that of you for, about your suffering or any other sentence showing empathy. This is regarding the first session. In the second session, you gave a good diagnosis that you didn't showed that you are certain because it could be another thing. But it was better if you tell what other diseases that you were thinking of. Mm-hmm. And it was nice that you reassured the patient to some extent and to tell him that the definite diagnosis will be later. Thank you for your nice encounter.
and I hope I gave you a good feedback.
Thank you.
Followed by a hand feedback. Like, just speak for half a minute. Again, I'll just mic on the kalam because. Are you please? Just take it there. So there was R1 student, resident, and we have. تسمعوني ترى أنا لما أمسك كذا أحس كأني مطرب. طيب. So. صح طيب لا والله هذا أزين شوية شوية أحسن. والله إذا شافتني زوجي ترى تبهدلني إنه وين بديت تغني. طيب. So. There was tutor or you can say who really gave the feedback. I want you to really think positively. And usually feedback should go in that way. So let us enumerate the person who was giving feedback, what he did very well. And then we'll come to the area for improvement, as he has discussed also better. Yes. So I want to listen. Now, we just enumerate. I say that the guy who was giving the feedback, he did this, and he did this, and he did this. That was very, very well. And that's the one. That's the really things that we have to do in our feedback. And then we show what area to be improved. May I tell them? Friendly. Yeah, I think I love it, really. That when it's not the, I mean, consultant, because he's acting as a consultant, and he will be just soon consultant. So this way. So he started and said that you did a great job and other things that could be also taken. We maybe comment later on that you did a great job. That's the one. Just remind me that we can discuss about that. What else? Just let us there, then when we look at it. So Doctora, she has, so let us listen from you and then we see what Doctora said. And then maybe we are going to do one more role play to improve our giving skills of feedback. Any other points? Okay. Okay. That's the. What to say? And even if you want to say to someone to improve, and this is the there are studies, Ali. And now if you tell him the good things, so فتح صدره يعني now وسع صدره يعني I don't know how to translate in English. توسيع الصدر كيف لا صعب لا خطيرة دي so mean ah yeah so he put him in the non-threatening setting والله حلوة هذه إني ترجمة الوسع الصدر okay so he put him in the non-threatening and now the things are accepted يعني whatever will come ونفس الشيء سويها مع أم العيال So want to say something, oh, we praise, oh, Allah, you're doing a good job, oh, Allah, the Saghir. So that's very important, to start with that. Any other point? Yeah, تفضل. ترفع صوتك شوي. Excellent. So that's again, and you mean, so that's very important. People, they think, even resident, we have seen, we have, I mean, 3 years experience that we have applied this workplace risk assessment. So student also they think that only, or the trainee, they think that only things which has to be improved to be said to them. Not the things that they have done well. That we know that. It's not that. They should know also the things which you have done well to be said to continue that. That's the things. And ma tawil, let us see what Doctora she is going to tell us very briefly. And then we try to say that can we change? There is some we have not taken the area for improvement. But definitely, the biggest room, I have learned from one of our tutors, the biggest room is room for improvement. So whenever it is there, so there is whenever we reflect
on our working. I'll go home, and then I reflect what we had done in this workshop. Yes, it was nice. People, they were happy. But what are the area for improvement for next time? And then we can improve that. Tfadli.
Thanks for the provided feedback. The provided feedback from the resident, the provided feedback from you to the one play the role of the teacher. And I want to say, you know, it seems that we all agree on the three important questions when it comes to the feedback. What was done well, what could be done better, and what could be done to improve next time. Like, can I disagree, or the recent trends disagree with something? And no, it shouldn't be a one-way feedback. And then a haga asma, the old feedback sandwich. An old feedback sandwich can praise, criticize, and then praise. And everybody was seeing it's palatable. Like, in actually, it's not very much palatable. And no, this way, the feedback is coming just from the feedback provider or the teacher and going in one way to the learner. And of course, this has some disadvantages, and you all can imagine how much the resident is agreeing with what's being said. This is number one. Number two, how much is he involved in his plan for further improvement? Number three, you know, we miss something very important, which is training our residents on the skill of self-assessment. I should be able to assess myself and my performance. This is a skill that is gained by time. So we shifted to the new feedback sandwich. The new feedback sandwich starts with ask, tell, and then ask. If I start by asking the resident, in your opinion, what went well? And he starts to give some sort of self-assessment about what his points of strengths from his own point of view. And then we go to what are the areas do you think that needs improvement? And again, he self-assesses himself and he provides this. Provided that both of us are providing feedback in relevance to certain benchmark. Yani, this is not personal, this is not judgmental. مش حكاية استظرفت دم أو استثقلته. لا. I'm providing the feedback as based on the items I have learned that are present within my checklist for training, my checklist for assessment, and so on. Then comes the tell. I comment on what he has mentioned. I might agree with him in some items or disagree with him on others. And it ends by asking him once more. The final ask would be, if he has any comments about what I have mentioned, the problem with the one-way feedback, and you don't get answers, you don't get reflections, and maybe justifications. You don't explore the way he's thinking. The final ask is quite important also because we agree together on a plan for improvement. Like, in the coming 6 months, what should I do to improve? What are the resources I need? And if the teacher can help with this. So it ends with the ask, tell, ask, which is the current strategy preferred for the provision of feedback. Feedback techniques to be adopted, including creating a respectable, all-minded, non-threatening climate. And we all have agreed that our resident has done this in a very efficient manner. Eliciting thoughts and feelings before giving feedback. Of course, if I just started to provide the feedback without the first ask, I'm not provoking here or eliciting any thoughts. He's just ready, passive, and ready to hear my own point of view. Using language that is non-evaluative, non-judgmental. It's quite important, you know, I evaluate versus clear benchmark, certain items or competencies. Inama, it's not the way that how he looks, how it's not personal, and it should not be affected with any previous experiences I had with the candidate. Focusing on specific behaviors, as we have mentioned, basing feedback on observed facts, and I think that during the provision of the feedback, he provided something which is measurable, observable. He said, you asked repeatedly about so and so and so. Giving feedback in small digestible quotations or quotes, yani, it's preferred, you know, When I'm talking about the positive points or the negative points, for instance, in history taking, I don't go and tell him history taking perfect. No. But few points, no. Your ability for history, the history you have taken was focused as required, logical, goes in appropriate sequence. You've asked about the different types of histories you're expected and things like this. But at the same time, for instance, you didn't focus on whatever. Suggesting ideas for improvement, this comes with the last ask. I ask him about how he would improve his points of weakness, maintain the points of strength, and we share together in drafting a plan for improvement. You as a teacher, you as an expert, you are to provide for him suggestions as regards the resources or as regards the time frame he might need to develop any or each of the skills of or competencies. When it comes to the provision of feedback, we want to say that it should be a two-way feedback. Never use one-way feedback. Use the ask, tell ask. Still, we are telling what was done better at the beginning, going to what could be done better and what could be done to improve next time. And you see even the phrasing of the questions, it is done in a manner so that the whole setting is friendly. Yeah, and we didn't say, what are your points of weakness? What errors you have made, or such sort of things. We always give the candidate the sense that he is in a process of continuous improvement throughout his career. وأي حد فينا, at any stage of his life, he might receive feedback for improvement. For this is a culture, في الحقيقة, that should be transmitted to the residents, will teachers. This is how to provide the feedback. الصورة دينا حطيتها tricky. علشان أول ما هنقول how you provide feedback, it always comes to your mind what are the good things and what are the bad things. وده طبعاً كان the classical way of providing feedback. Do you have any comments on the process of provision of feedback? Yes. Okay. First, I start by asking the resident of some sort of self-assessment. Okay, Ahmed, tell me. In your opinion, what went well and what areas you need to be better in the next time? So Ahmed starts to say, I have taken the history so, it was logical. He begins to mention his points of strength. And then thereafter, he goes to the areas that need improvement, or he thinks that this should be better in the next time. This is the ask. And then we go to the tell. I start telling him, yes, Ahmed, I agree with you that you have taken the history in an efficient manner. It was logical, in good sequence, included all of the components, but at the same time, whatever. And I want to say something. You know, some of the students have tendency to underestimate themselves. يعني قصة, it's not only overestimation. أحيانا الناس ما عندهمش قدرة to do good self-assessment. So he might evaluate himself less than the way you're going to evaluate him. For I want him to gain the skill of self-assessment. لأنه for any self-learning or continuous professional development, he should be able to self-assess himself. Thereafter, I mentioned to him his the good points and the bad points, طبعا in a non-judgmental way. And then at the end, I start asking him once more. So okay, in your opinion, what would you do to improve the areas in need improvement that we have reached? And then he starts to say, I need to work on myself in 1, 2, 3, 4. And I ask him once more, in what time frame, what resources do you think are efficient in order to improve those areas? And I start suggesting me, myself. So by the end, we have reached a clear plan for improvement of whatever he has. And I say one thing very important. I was talking with one of the professors outside. Sorry, I'm bad at names. Like a very important point was raised. And I would like to tell you something about Bardo Hagam, the recent trends in clinical skills training and simulation, if you're using simulation. And when we reach a point of weakness, in the old days, we had our physicians or learners to repeat all of the training. يعني for instance, لو حد احنا بنشوفه في procedure معين, okay? like examination of something, certain procedure, suturing, whatever. الترند العادي إنه the regular trend or the routine trend إنه if there are some essential steps that he didn't perform well, we send him backwards for having a training session for the whole of the procedure from the start. Worldwide, this is not the trend currently. The trend is that we do two things. First, I give the cognitive component for any skill. The theory, the anatomical structure, the steps of the procedure, the indications, and that sort of things. And then I have a test, a post-test. The recent trends in all learners should be very proficient in this test. Yani people are talking of a full mark before you proceed to the clinical component. When you go to the clinical component as such, I'm quite sure if you do any mistakes, these are not related to the cognitive background. And the research have found that 60% of the errors that occur during the practice of certain skill are due to deficiencies in the cognitive or knowledge background relative to the skill. طيب, جينا عملنا السكيل, whatever you call it, even if it is history taking. الشيكليست for training should include all of the steps in details. What's more important, to include all the common errors from the literature and from your own experience. So as the learner is aware of. طيب, during assessment or practice, اكتشفنا ان في certain step فيها مشكلة. بنعمل حاجة دلوقتي اسمها deliberate practice. Deliberate practice means that he is to go and get extensive training on the deficient step. كويس؟ وده الرمدي اللي بيتعمل. I want to say, if you're providing feedback to one of the learners, I'm not going to say that for the whole skill, you don't know how to do it. لو أنا كمان مش في Mini-Cex, لو أنا في Mini-Cex, لو أنا في Direct Observation of Proceeding, I might pinpoint الحاجة معينة فيها deficiency, and when we're planning for remedy or for improvement, he is to go and have deliberate practice on this specific component that he is deficient in. ده less burden على الـ trainers و less time consuming للترينيه. والحاجة التانية أنا بدل ما أنا I'm consuming 2 hours for a whole skill, the 2 hours would be for the step which is deficient. لكن كل ده is dependent on the situation, and my checklist for training and assessment is detailed enough, contains the common errors well, بحيث أنها تساعدني to pinpoint المشكلة. لأنه أحيانا when it is generic من غير metrics واضحة زي ما كنا بنقول appropriate مش عارف مين ما بيبقاش عندي القدرة الكافية, I don't have the ability to identify the exact points that needs remediation and things like this. يبقى, what I want to conclude with, it's not only Mini-Cex, it's not only the way of assessment that you are using. دي منظومة. It starts with a well-written curriculum that includes competencies, clear objectives, educational methods that are detailed, help you to master whatever you're doing and to know how are you going to be assessed. وبعدين it ends with an assessment system that includes both ASCII for competency or to the demonstrate how, and then the highest level, which is performance at the workplace. Fine? Any questions? Any comments? عايزين تروحوا بين خالص. One comment. حضرتك لازم تعرف إنه الهدف, the aim of the feedback is not only improvement of deficient areas. Maintenance of areas of strength is another important issue. فمش حكاية إن you know your points of strength. I might discuss with you how you build on these. يعني افرض إن you have certain capabilities or certain competencies which are doing well. We can discuss together how to get this maintained or much more improved. Right?
What I'm going to do now, step three. What I'm going to do. really, I'm very happy that people have started giving feedback and so, and we don't have the culture and so. Let us quickly ask you that if you reflect on what you are doing with Dr. Ahmed, how did you work? What are the things you thought that you did really well?
Well, I think I did that okay, because from his reaction, he didn't, was not upset or he didn't seem like he didn't like it. I addressed good and bad things, but one thing I missed.
No. I want to raise the area where the, usually you think that was strong and you did well. And then we go for the other thing, area for you. Let us just discuss about the area which you think that you did well.
I start with positive things.
Okay.
I pointed to the negative things and less harsh or harmful things.
Go to the area. I can say that there are a lot of other points. I mean, you really made it two parts. You said, let me discuss the first part, and then you're discussing about that. And then you said that second part, and discussing about that. That's really made the trainee more clear for him, isn't it?
Yes.
So that's what another point. Any other point? We're still in the positive. I have a list of positive points which you have done.
I do not.
So when you're telling about that, you are asking questions, yes and no. Maybe trainee, which is first year, he was just watching the questions, yes and no. Then it was followed by that you did not ask open-ended questions. That's really I love it. So you showed what was not doing and how to do that. That's again, and I found it that was really good. You pinpointed that the questions were some questions were repeated, and then we discuss about that. I think there are so many, just for the time, the points were there that you did really very well, and I love the way that you discussed. Okay, let us go for the area for improvement. So what are the things that you think that if you are going for the next feedback, so what are the area you think that in general that you have to improve?
I thought if I had given the chance to talk about his opinion about himself first.
Awesome. So that's the one, that's the self-assessment was done there. You know, I was better looking at the time, you took 3.5 minutes. What is the time you think that the guy he has taken to talk? And what is the time you have taken to talk?
30% of the time. Or maybe one quarter of the time.
I think the majority you were talking. Because it's just in the beginning, he talked and then this was on.
Yeah, but he should have talked more.
It's in, yeah, so at least, they say that feedback should be the two ways. So if you really want to evaluate yourself, you think that how much you have taken the 5 minutes or whatever it is, how much we have given the time that he should have. That's the very important. So self-assessment was missing, the two ways that things were missing, what else? That's good to get in. But what else to do more exploration? You know, it's that nice to say that he should identify that what are the area that the self-assessment we're talking about. And then if he say that, yes, I was talking, then we can add to that. And when you say that you were asking yes and no questions, is there any way of asking something else? Instead of giving the open-ended, possibly, I'm not sure, possibly he was not aware of what is open-ended question. Listen, for you as a senior, you know that what is open-ended question. But possibly the junior doctor who just joined the program, he doesn't know that what is open-ended question. So even if you say that what is yes or no, it is yes or no question, it doesn't work well, and why? I mean that, and then you say that open-ended question, and then you ask, are you aware that what is. So it'll be more sticky, isn't it? That will be more what else? You said there are certain negative points, isn't it? You're talking about the certain negative points, and you said those things. People are now moving from telling negative.